Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chill in colors on the snowy linen land.
What sort of encouragement did you receive from your family?
Quite obviously, I was going to get quite a lot of oppression from them. For instance, they didn't know that I did my A-level art until I'd done it afterwards. But I think that's quite understandable when you appreciate that most parents come to this country for the betterment of their children. I think they want an academic career for them, a secure career.
Where do you find the inspiration for the paintings that you do?
I think the paintings must be related directly to your environment. You're trying to depict a certain atmosphere or emotion that really comes out directly from the contact you have with people, with places, things. But I don't really mean that as the immediate environment. I think that must be extended to a wider category. For instance, if I did a painting in Pakistan that depicted poverty, I don't think that I would just like the painting to be restricted to the audiences in Pakistan. I would probably want it to travel to Britain and be appreciated by people there.
There does seem to be a great deal of suffering and torment in evidence in your work. Yeah. Where does that come from?
Well, when I started painting in university, when I started seriously thinking, I was looking for ways to convey some of my experiences in Pakistan. I mean, obviously, there weren't that much. I was only up there for about 8 years, but I think those early years are very important in moulding your thoughts thereafter. And I think I was trying to capitalize on the situations or atmospheres I could recall at that age, for instance, poverty. And obviously that's evident in some of the traditional and conventional themes that I started off with. The Whisper is an example. Actually, the inspiration came from A-level that I had done. I think the question was something like, examine the problem of color in shadows. And at that time, my grandmother had come from Pakistan, and I managed to get a shot of her and my brother in such a position. I think it doesn't only relate to my colour, but also to the experiences I did have in Pakistan in some of the subjects like this. I think talking about them now, they may be a bit superficial, because obviously, as a child, you're probably not sceptical to some of the problems that do exist in such a culture. And they were really me trying to relate myself living in a totally different culture into the one I had originally been, and trying to put that on paper. I think that the predominant use of colours was quite evident of the culture-based paintings that I started off quite early on.
Is there any particular painter whose style has influenced you?
Obviously, I would choose Picasso, because I think he was just a prolific master. He could do a painting in whatever style he wanted to and still be recognizable as a Picasso. But I think the abstraction school attracts me to an extent, because mainly it's a most aesthetic form of art. And one of the characteristics encompassed in that is that the process of creation is left to the spectator rather than the artist himself.
What sort of reaction have you received when people view your work?
Mainly mixed, I think. I don't think... I think it really depends on what your aim is in the work. I think you're trying to really portray your feelings and emotions. And you're trying to provoke the spectator in picking out his feelings that he can relate to the work that you have done. So I don't know if I would find sort of audience for the work, but at the university, in the exhibition, the reaction has been quite positive.
How come an artist like you is reading commerce at university? Isn't that a strange choice?
It was really an attempt to pursue my academic career. because obviously it's an obligation to my parents. I had to really succeed in my other side as well, just to be safe, as it were, and so that it wouldn't be any hardship for my parents.
You've not had a formal training in art, Nasser. Do you regret that?
No, I don't think so, because I would have probably found it very difficult to enter art school at that time. Secondly, in retrospect, I don't think I would have really learned a lot from art school. It's mainly because I probably would have got technical benefits, but that's really it. The inspiration really must come from somewhere else.
And would you say that your work is politically motivated?
Oh, not at all, I don't think. Maybe religious to an extent, that I see, I tend to seek help from God rather than religion. I will start the painting in the name of God. So I think that's mainly so that I can succeed in my aim rather than anything else.